Hello, it's Keith here, and this is lesson 25 of the platform-specific series of my 6502 assembly programming tutorials. We're going to look at the PC engine this week, also known as the TurboGrafx, and we're going to learn how to make simple sounds on this system. Now, the PC engine has a very powerful sound chip. It's capable of 6 channels, and these use wave samples, so we give it very small samples of 32 bytes, only 5 bits per byte though, and these will actually define a sound sample. We're going to just create a simple square wave, and we're also going to learn how to make noise samples as well, because it has its own dedicated noise effects that it can do. Now, when it comes to using the systems in our 6502 tutorials and originally the Z80 tutorials as well, we're going to create a little program that I call chibisound. Now, this is kind of a sound driver. It takes a single byte and the bits in the byte are split up, and 6 of the bits define a pitch. 1 bit defines a high or low volume, and 1 bit defines the noise on or off. So we either have a noised sample or we have a regular square wave tone. So we're using these 8 bits as a way of simply defining sounds, and give or take, the sounds are kind of similar on all of the systems, although of course the systems are widely different in their sound capabilities. But the point is that if we're making a little game and we need some shooting sounds in our Space Invaders type game or something, we can use chibisound to get our game have playing sounds on all of the systems across all of my tutorial series in roughly the same way. Given the same input, you'll get a sort of similar sound coming out. So that's what we're going to do today. We're going to have a go with the sound system of the PC engine, and we're going to write the chibisound driver. Now, the sound system on the PC engine is pretty easy to use. We've got these hardware ports here. These are memory mapped. Now, by default, they're in the zero range. So we're using 0800 to 0809, and these will control everything. So we basically have a channel select here, which will select one of the 6 channels. You can see there's just 3 bits used here. We then select the master volume. That's kind of the mixer volume for all of the channels. We then have a low and high frequency here. So that's 12 bits in total. And then we've got the volume here, and we've got an enable and a data write option here. Now this is for when we need to write sample data. We'll get to that in just a moment. We then have an extra volume. Now this is the channel volume. So we have a master volume and a channel volume. So if we want to turn everything down, we'd use this. If we want to make one channel quieter, we'd use this one. Then we've got our wave data here. We need to write 32 times to this single address, but remember only bits 0 to 4 are used here. And then we've got a noise option. We can turn noise on with the top bit here, and we can select the frequency with the bottom one here. And we've got some LFO options here. Okay, so that's the basics of the hardware ports and what each one does. Let's have a look at chibisound and let's hear it in action. Okay, so here's chibisound playing. Now, here you can see the byte that is being sent to chibisound, and up here you can see the waveform visually. So you can see we've got a square wave here, and it's getting smaller as the frequency goes up. Now, anything above hexadecimal 80 is a noise effect, which you can hear now, and so this is a very jagged, random sample here. You can hear once again the pitch is changing. Now, when the top bit is 1, we've got noise. When the next bit 6 is 1, then we've got a loud sound, otherwise we've got quiet, and you can hear the quieter ones here. And now we've gone into the loud tones again. So you can hear here that depending on that byte that we pass to chibisound, we get a very different sound. So let's have a look at the actual code that does the job. Well, it's this chibisound call here. You can just see it in our code here. Our code's very simple. Really all we're doing is loading A with a value. We are just showing it to the screen. That's all this code does. We call chibisound, and then we just pause for a while. We've got a pause command here. And we just loop around, decreasing the accumulator one by 1 each time. Okay, so let's have a look at chibisound. So this will, in its entirety, do all of the sound processing for what we're doing today. So the first thing we're doing is we're selecting a channel. This is port 0800 here, and we're selecting channel 5. Now you can see here, we've used this port just here, and of course we're selecting channel 5. Now why are we selecting channel 5? Now in the case of the tone, we could use channel 0, that would possibly be more sensible. However, the noise effect is only possible on channels 4 and 5. So we're selecting channel 5 because we're going to use it for the noise effect for when that top bit is 1. The top bit here defines the noise on or the noise off for the plain tone. Right, so we've selected our channel 5. Now we're going to write the data. So we store a 0 to 804. We're using the SDZ command, which is a non-standard 6502 command, but this just writes a 0 quickly to hexadecimal 804 memory address. This tells the system that we're going to write data, and by definition, it turns the channels sound off. Now we're going to write the data. So we're going to write 8 chunks of 4 bytes. Now, as I said, it's only 5 bits of data that we can write. So we're loading the accumulator with the bottom 5 bits as 1. And then we are going to write that value 4 times. So we write the byte in the accumulator to 0806. And we do that 4 times. Then what we do is we flip all of the bits. And then we repeat 8 times. Effectively, we're building a square wave. So we'll have 4 consecutive bytes of one value, then we flip all the bits and have 4 consecutive bytes of the other value. We're repeating this 8 times to make up the 32 bytes of data for that sample. So we're effectively building our wave sample for the square wave here. Okay, now once we've done this, we're then returning our accumulator here, which is the value here, and then we're checking if it's 0. Now if it is 0, then we are defining that we want to turn the sound off, because there's a sort of special case that if all the bits are 0, we silence the sound processor. So if it's not 0, then we're continuing here, but if it is the case, we're just returning, because remember I said before that by definition writing a 0 to 804 is turning the sound processor off, and you can see that just here. Here's the volume bits. So if we write all of these to 0, then we are effectively silencing the sound, and also if the top bit is 0, then we're disabling the sound altogether anyway. So that is now going to be silent. Okay, so what we're going to do next? Well, we've now got a wave sample, but we need to actually set up the other parameters. The first one we're going to do is the volume. We're going to be using 804 again, and we need to turn on the sound this time, and we need to have these bits here, these ones here, set to the correct volume. Now, this uses 5 bits for the volume definition, but our definition is just using a single bit, just this one here. So what we're doing is we're filtering out this one bit from the accumulator, shifting it to the right, to this position here, and then setting all the other bits to 1. This has the effect of allowing for a loud volume where all the bits are 1, or a quiet volume if this bit was 0 here in the accumulator, and then this will be 0 just here. So writing to here now turns the channel on, and it sets the correct volume depending on the accumulator. Right, so there we go. Now what we need to do is we need to set the master volume. So we're doing that just here. We're setting the left and right panning. We're setting it to center here, and we're setting this one as well. We want it just to be a central channel. So writing 255 to both of these does that. Our next stage is going to be the pitch. Now the definition that chibisound is passed uses 6 bits. So we're going to need to split those up. Now, if you look at the pitch definition here, we've effectively got 4 bits here, and we've got 8 bits here. Now, we've only got 6 bits in our definition, and the way we're going to split it up is we're going to take the top 4 bits of the pitch definition in the accumulator, that's these ones here, and we're going to write them to 803. Now, you can see 803 is just here. But then we're going to take the remaining 2 bits, and we're going to store those to 802. And we're going to store those just to here. And of course, the other bits will be 0 in this case. So we're defining the pitch across those 2 registers in the hardware here, based on the 6 bits within our definition. The last stage is going to be the noise. So we're testing to see if bit 7 is 1 or 0. If it's a 0, then there's no noise. So we're just jumping to here, and we're turning the noise off by writing a 0 here. And then if it's not a 0, we're going into this stage here. What we're doing now is we're getting that frequency back from the accumulator, because although we've set the tone frequency here, that's not enough to set the noise frequency. So we're doing that just here. Now, if you look at the noise frequency here, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 bits. Now, our definition up here has 6 bits for the pitch, so we don't have enough bits. So what we're doing here is we're taking the top 5 bits of the noise of the frequency, we're shifting it to the right by 1, and we're then setting the top bit to 1 because we want to enable the noise. We're doing that by setting the carry and doing another rotate. And then we're jumping back to here, and we're storing the accumulator, which will now be the noise definition, to 807. Whereas if there was no noise, we were setting the accumulator to 0. So either way, we set 807, which is of course the noise enable here, and then we're returning. And that's really all there is to doing this. Now, if you wanted, another alternative would have been we could generate noise samples using the wave data if we wanted. We could have created wave noise, but in my experience that can be quite difficult to create convincing noise. So being as there is a noise generator built in, I would recommend this as the better way of doing things. But of course that is another alternative, just create random data for your wave data just here. So really that's all there is to it. The PC Engine once again is really quite straightforward. It's got a good set of features, you know, great panning options here, 6 channels, digital sound. Very straightforward to get simple sounds working on it. So again, I think this is another case where the PC Engine is really a nice, simple way of getting fairly decent, powerful functionality quickly compared to something like the Atari Lynx or compared to the Super Nintendo. PC Engine makes it nice and easy for us. It's definitely a system I'd suggest you look at if you want to make 16-bit quality games without too much effort. Anyway, there we go. That's all we're going to be doing today. We're going to be coming back to the PC Engine later on. I've got a sprite tutorial planned, so please stick around for that. If you liked this lesson, please like and subscribe, and we'll do some more later on. Anyway, thanks for watching today, and goodbye.